Galite kalbėti.
Gerbėmėjai svečiai, mėly žiūrovai, kolegos.
Dear friends, welcome everybody attending this festive online opening event of the exhibition Nordic Children's Book Flood. Pepe, long stockings, trolley mummy, the dwarf Nils, Tobias and Carlson. Santa Claus, these characters take us in a spur of a moment to magical childhood memories. It's not one generation, it's more than one for sure, that has grown up surrounded by these beloved characters. The characters who have come to us from the Nordic literature. And today we are this unique opportunity, unprecedented opportunity to go on a journey full of adventures, literary journey in a symbolic shift, which this book flood has brought to our library. And you are most welcome, all of you, those who have the spirit of adventure, who are curious about what is happening in the field of literature, to get even more familiar with the most famous characters of the Nordic books. The first, actually, exhibition of such book flood was held in 2018 in Iceland, during the commemoration of the 50th anniversary of the Nordic House. Then the following year, this interactive exposition went to Latvia, to Latvian National Library. And this year, we are just proud to be hosting this exhibition in Lithuania, in the Panevėžys County, Gabrielė Petkevičaitė Bitė Public Library. It will run until October, and you are all welcome. Both the young, very young, and older just visitors of our library. And you'll have this, again, unique opportunity to get acquainted with the classical and modern literature of the Nordic literature and its characters. And we are also, this is, as I said, it's unprecedented exhibition. And again, we are happy to have the famous Icelandic writer, illustrator, Kristín Ragna Gunnarsdóttir, who really has thought of a unique way to include children into the exhibition so that they become part of the exhibition. Kristín also organized the creative workshop during which she presented in a thorough manner the literature of the Nordic countries and the most important characters. And all the features of the characters also have been disclosed. And those children who were just attending those workshops, they were asked to draw two heroes, characters, one from the Nordic countries, one from their own childhood. And you see those characters waving to you, bidding welcome the moment you enter the library. And of course, professional, diverse, creative, professional team contributed towards arranging this exhibition. This is the writer, illustrator Kotrina Zilė, architect Justina Zudienas, Marius Lukošinas, also Justinas Vansevičius, who is the leader of the Literary Cognition Program for Children and Adolescents, Vaikų Žemė. And you'll have lots of tasks, lots of challenges to overcome, and you'll see the giant ship in Atrius Terrace. Also, you'll be given lots of tasks, such as, let's say, fishing, the bottles, finding out many interesting facts about the Vikings, maybe send a message to the other fisherman who will come after you. There will be also the drawing wall, and you could become the illustrators. If you like to rhyme or to create poems, you are most welcome to disclose and unleash your talent. And you will be asked to, it's like pokey rhyming, to write the second line of the rhyme on your own. And also, you will go underwater and you will meet Pippi Longstocking and the other characters. You will also have the stamps. You will be able to stamp your your presence. I would like to express heartfelt thanks to the organizers of this exhibition. This is the Panevėžys County Gabriela Petkevičaitė Bitė Public Library and the Nordic Council of Ministers Office in Lithuania. Also, our heartfelt thanks go to our sponsors, the Nordics, Nordic Council of Ministers, Reykjavik UNESCO City of Literature, and Panevėžys City Municipality. And now, the welcome word, well, just the floor is given to the head of, director of our library, Jurgita Bugailiškienė. Welcome, everybody, dear Vice Minister, dear Mayor of Panevėžys, dear all our guests from Iceland, from Reykjavik, from the other cities and towns of Lithuania, dear listeners or viewers, dear visitors, yes, those who are together with us during this festive online opening event of the exhibition. And when we have been first given this offer to plan this exhibition, we were taken aback. I mean, by the mastermind, Christine Ragnar Gudardorsir, we thought it was amazing. This exhibition unleashing the creative potential of our little ones. And of course, we needed, just to make this idea or dream come true, we needed a team of true professionals. And how was it possible to transfer, to move that exhibition, which was mounted in Reykjavik in Iceland, to Panevėžys, to Lithuania? How could we possibly adapt and adjust the scenario of the exhibition to Lithuania needs? And we are indeed happy for the contribution of the creative team. And this was a mixture of something that is traditional old, something that's innovative. Also, it's kind of a bridge between the old and the new, between different cultures. And look at this outcome, look at this result. This is, I think, we are really good at inviting the little ones to be immersed into this trip, imaginary trip, going into that ship. And now, what? I wish you a very nice opening ceremony, and I think you will enjoy what you hear. Thank you, dear director, and I am sure we're not going to forget these experiences. And now, it's my pleasure to give the floor to Vice Minister of Culture, Rimantas Mikaitis. Hello, everybody. Nordic literature has been accompanying our Lithuanian children for more than several decades. I'm an adult, but I can still remember and describe my beloved characters, Nordic literature characters, and Pippi Longstocking, and whatnot. Many of them are Dwarf Nils and Tobias. And Carl's son who lives on the roof. And all of us who in one or another way has come close to the Nordic literature for children cannot forget the impression. And I'm saying this not only as the Vice Minister of Culture, but also as the grandfather having a brilliant, most bright granddaughter. And I can see how much she's attached to these characters. And again, I'm sure that this exhibition is a tremendous input to promote reading among our little ones. And also, I am happy to see such creators, such talents who have contributed towards arranging this library. And let this book flood flood us around, not only the children, but the adults, the grown-ups as well. We need that. Thank you very much. Thank you, dear Vice Minister of Culture, for your nice words. And right now, It's my pleasure again to give the floor to the mayor of Panevėžy City, Mykolas Račkauskas. Thank you. Well, me too. I can only repeat what has been said. I cannot forget, even as an adult, all those unique, all those mesmerizing stories from the Nordic literature. And I don't think we can count the number of children who have been reading those books, I mean, Nordic books, and of course, including Lithuanian children as well. And it's such immense pride that I take in being the mayor of Panevėžy, just because we are hosting this book flood exhibition today. And I'm quite sure that this exhibition will inspire many more children and probably grown-ups to spread their wings, to carry on their dreams. And thank you so much. It's truly such a significant event. Thank you, dear mayor of Panevėžy City. I'm quite sure that, yes, that the kids will enjoy this imaginary trip. And now it's my pleasure to give the word to Ms. Helen Nielsen, head of the Nordic Council office in Vilnius.
Thank you, dear Vice Minister, dear mayor of Panevėžy. Good morning, Iceland, and good afternoon to all of us here in Lithuania. It's symbolic that we are opening at last this children book exhibition today on the International Children's Day. Children and young people are the priority target group for the Nordic Council of Ministers, with the vision of the Nordic region being the best place in the world for children and young people. The Council wants to ensure that the region is a pioneer in efforts to create a society that respects the rights and perspectives of children and young people and give them the opportunity to contribute to the way in which their society develops. The Nordic Council of Ministers' offices in the Baltic countries have a long history of promoting Nordic culture and literature by implementing annual literature and reading, promoting events such as the Nordic Literature Week, Nordic authors' visit to the Baltic countries, organizing creative workshops for children, book exhibition, creative writing camps for young people. We want to contribute to promoting contemporary Nordic literature. We would like to present winners and nominees of the Nordic Council of Literature Prize and the Nordic Council Children and Young People's Literature Prize, encouraging new translations and support reading in general, of course. Therefore, we are more than happy to accept the offer of our Nordic sister organization, the Nordic House in Reykjavik, to host an interactive children books exhibition in Lithuania, and are extremely grateful to the actual host of the exhibition, Panevėžy County Library, the authors, the curator of the exhibition, Kristina Ragna Gunnarsdottir, our great cooperation partner, Vaiku Seme, and our colleagues in the other Nordic Council of Ministers offices in Latvia and Estonia. Nordic children literature has been popular in the Baltic countries for years. Children in all age has been growing up with and surrounded by beloved characters of books by Astrid Lindgren, Tove Jansson, Gunilla Bergström, Julia Wislande, and so many, many more. With this exhibition, we would like to remind the classics, but also introduce new Nordic children literature to young readers, as well as professionals working in the publishing industry, educational sector, and the library field. But also to give a chance to compare the Nordic and the Baltic children books, the themes, the heroes that can be of all kinds, to find similarities and or differences in the literature in our Nordic Baltic region. Reading for the sake of enjoyment can, among other things, steer readers onto new paths, stimulate the imagination, expand the vocabulary, as well as the horizon. And of course, it contribute to empathy and open-mindedness. Getting children to be interested in reading books can be reached effectively through place and creativity. So we hope that the books in the treasure box I have heard about in this exhibition will let the youngest readers enjoy the stories, book illustrations, find new heroes, and get the feeling of the world that is much smaller than one may think, and that we have much in common in our region. Maps and books will be there for reading, sharing, enjoying, or creating whatever one may come up with. A bridge, a tower, an island, a football, or a basketball, who knows? We believe this exhibition will serve as a nice example of a child-centered approach in its whole setup, the architecture, adjustment of the exhibition space with its interactive elements that will allow children to experience culture in new ways, at their own way and with their own, so to say, eye level. With this, let me once again thank you all the partners and contributors, and warmly welcome children, families, kindergarten groups, schools, classes to visit the exhibition throughout the summer. And I myself, I really, really hope that I soon can come to Panevėžys and also visit the exhibition. Thank you all.
Dėkojame gerbiamai Helen Nilsson.
Thank you, dear Helen Nilsson. We really do hope that you will visit our exhibition more than once. As I said, it runs until the 1st of October. And meaning we have so many challenges, so many interesting activities here that I can't even start to talk. And now it's my pleasure to introduce dear Sabina Westerholm, head of the Reykjavik Nordic House.
Hello, greetings from Reykjavik. My name is Sabina Westerholm and I am the director of the Nordic House. Thank you for having me. Culture builds bridges and the Nordic House is a bridge builder. In fact, the Nordic House was founded in 1968 to establish a culture bridge between Iceland and the other Nordic countries. Literature has from the start been very important for the Nordic House. We run the most beautiful house, the most beautiful library in Iceland, as you can see. And we also accommodate the secretariat for the two Nordic Council Literature Prizes. Children and children's families are our most important guests. And our children's library has become a really popular place now during the last years for families in Reykjavik to just hang out in. And when the Nordic House turned 50 years old in 2018, we wanted to do something really special for our small guests and at the same time celebrate the Nordic children's literature. So we invited the Icelandic children's books author, Kristin Ragna Gunnarsdottir, to curate an interactive exhibition where children could learn and create. The exhibition, The Children's Book Flood, was extremely popular and it was visited by thousands of children here in Iceland or here in the Nordic House during the fall of 18 and the spring of 19. So we are really happy that the exhibition concept now has traveled to the Baltic countries. Since the early 1990s, the Nordic Council of Ministers has worked closely together with Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania. And we here in the Nordic House in Reykjavik have made a strategic decision to feature the Baltics in a larger extent in our culture program. And this because we here in Iceland have a significant representation of people with Baltic backgrounds. So at the moment here in the Nordic House, we celebrate the Baltic Children Culture Festival. The program is broad and diverse, and it has been planned together in collaboration with the Lithuanian and Latvian schools and with creative professionals from the Baltics. Some of the events are aimed directly to people that speak Lithuanian, Latvian, and Estonian, and others are open for a wide audience, with the goal of presenting Baltic culture and Baltic traditions. With this initiative, we want to show that the Nordic House is an open and inclusive place that welcomes everyone, but we also want to counteract the often simplistic and negative representations of people with non-Icelandic backgrounds that prevail in media and in comment fields. The project has been very well received, and we hope to continue the collaboration also in the future. We have also a close relationship to the Nordic Council of Ministers' offices in the Baltic countries, and we have successfully collaborated with them before. A warm thank you to Director Helene Nilsson for a good collaboration, both here in Iceland and also there in Lithuania. And I also warmly want to thank the library for showing this exhibition and also everybody that has been working with it. And last but not least, I want to thank Kristin Ragna Gunnarsdottir for making it happen. So I want to end with sending my warmest good luck wishes for the exhibition. I hope it will be as popular as it was here in our house and that it will be visited by many, many, many happy children. Takk og bless from Iceland.
Dėkojame Sabinai Westerholm. Noriu tik pasakyti,
thank you, Sabina Westerholm. And I can reassure you that we're so happy, we all working at the library, of your initiative, just because it's thanks to you that we could host this exhibition in our library. And I'm quite sure that this library will become the highlight not only for Panevėžys residents, but for all Lithuanians. And right now, it's again my greatest pleasure to give the floor to Kristin Ragna Gunnarsdottir, who has been mentioned already several times, the famous Icelandic writer, illustrator, and I think she's going to introduce her own creation and
dear guests, on the opening of the Nordic Children's Book Flood. Do you hear me? If you could wave, just so that I'm sure. Okay, great. This is the constant terror of Zoom and technology that we are going through these times, so just bear with me. My name is Kristín Ragna Gunnarsdóttir. I'm an Icelandic writer, illustrator, teacher, and curator. And I'm the author and curator of this exhibition's predecessor, The Children's Book Flood in Iceland. The Children's Book Flood opened, as has been said before, at the Nordic House in Reykjavik in September of 2018. I have been asked to tell you a little bit about myself and my work so that you can get a sense of where the idea for this exhibition that is opening today came from. I studied graphic design and painting in Iceland, and alongside working in design and illustration, I took a BA degree in literature and a master's degree in creative writing. I have been working with our cultural heritage in one way or another ever since I finished art school. The edic... Okay, now we are starting with our problems here. Oh, there we go. The Eddic poems, the Prose Edda also, and Snorri's Edda, are the foundation of all our knowledge about Nordic mythology. They are based on an oral tradition of storytelling in Iceland that goes way back. The first book I worked on that comes from our literature heritage is this small book with a modern take on the Eddic poem Völuspá, which means the Sibyl's prophecy. In the poem, the Sibyl or seeress recalls all she can remember from her childhood amongst giants. She tells of how the worlds came to be, and then she gives her prophecy of the future events that lead to Ragnarök, the apocalypse of Nordic mythology. I was really inspired by Völuspá and have made many interpretations of the poem since then, including this wall mural. I longed to do something for younger readers in this area and got the author Þórarinn Eldjárn and Ingunn Ásdísardóttir to work on these picture books with me. Þórarinn Eldjárn rewrote Völuspá, the Sibyl's prophecy, for children. And here you can see a few illustrations from that book. We then moved on to do a remake of the Eddic poem Hávamál, which means Odin's words. In it, Odin gives us good advice on how to behave ourselves. He, for instance, doesn't want us to eat too much, and he says it's a really good idea to give our friends gifts because they will give us gifts back. I received Dimmalim, the Illustration Award in Iceland for this book, as well as this one here, The Fate of the Gods, that I worked on with the author Ingunn Ásdísardóttir. She retells a few of the stories that Snorri Sturluson wrote in his Poe's Edda. This collaboration led us to working on an exhibition that is now in the museum Víkingaheimur called The World of Vikings. And you can see that here. As you can see, I have never fully recovered after diving into this world of myths with all its colorful characters and creatures. So I moved on to write my own books. In the book series of Wolf and Edda, two children find a tunnel at a historical place in Iceland called Skálholt. The tunnel leads them to the world of the gods and Jötuns, and they get to know quite a few of the main characters of the myths. I give female characters the spotlight in this series, and that led me on to my next book series called, in English, A Story of Norns. In this book series, I have opened gates for three Norns from Nordic mythology to come to Iceland. And of course, they turn everything on its head. I am currently working on the third book in A Story of Norns, as well as illustrating a deck of tarot cards based on Völuspá that I previously exhibited in Seattle at the Nordic Historical Museum in the USA. And I am as well writing a play from the first book of Wolf and Edda for the National Theatre of Iceland. I have also worked in other areas of our literature heritage, for I have illustrated a few tapestries that are based on the Icelandic sagas. The largest one is the story of Burnt Njál's tapestry called Njálurevillinn. The tapestry is 90 meters long and is going to be installed for public viewing this summer. I have been fortunate to have the opportunity to work on quite a few interactive exhibitions for children. The first one was Ormurinn Ógnarlangi, the extremely long worm, which of course is the Midgarð serpent. I worked on this project with the creative team of the Art Center Gerðuberg and several of my students from the Art University of Iceland. This exhibition was later installed at the Children's Mental Hospital. And then I got to work on an exhibition for the Nordic House that promoted books and authors that were nominated for the Nordic Literature Prize in 2014. I curated this exhibition with another author, Davi Stefánsson, and the creative team within the Nordic House, as well as specialized artists and a few of my students worked on the production with us. The name of the exhibition, Háfugl út í mýri, Peacock in the Moor, is in connection with the international conference Mirin that is held at every other year at the Nordic House and promotes children's books and their authors. Mirin will be held at the Nordic House next October, and I believe that there will be guests there from Lithuania at the festival this year. In 2016, illustrations from my book Hávamál, Odin's Words, were chosen to be part of a traveling exhibition Into the Wind. The exhibition opened in Berlin and traveled to many countries during the next 2 years. It portrayed the best of what was going on in children's picture book illustration in the Nordic countries at the time. My book, Wolf and Edda, The Relic, was nominated for the Nordic Council Prize in Children's and Young People's Literature in 2017, and the West Nordic Council Council's Children and Youth Literature Prize in 2018. Through this, I got a chance to get to know Nordic children's books even more closely, as well as some of their authors and illustrators, and I was really impressed. Nordic children's books are both bold and are experimental in themes, as well as format and artistic styles. They encourage young people to be brave, think independently, and express their thoughts and feelings. I hope that more of the wonderful books nominated for the Nordic Council Literature Prize will be translated in the near future. Translations really build bridges. Now, all this led up to me being offered to create an exhibition on the 50th anniversary of the Nordic House in 2018. Mikkel Harder, the previous director of the Nordic House in Reykjavik, asked me to come up with a concept with emphasis on welcoming the next generation of guests, the young people. We discussed resources during our first meeting, and Mikkel said jokingly that if there was one thing that the Nordic House had enough of, it was books. I had been spending a lot of time on various committees promoting children's books and their importance in literacy, communication skills, and empathy, and all this fell into place in my idea for the Children's Book Flood. Regarding the name of the exhibition, it is an old Icelandic tradition to give books as Christmas presents. So most books are launched during a short period in the months before Christmas. This is called the Book Flood, and this is where the idea for the title came from. The production of the exhibition was due to the great team of creative people within the Nordic House, collaborating artists and sponsors that really believed in the project. Teamwork and mutual love for children's books and children's culture were the key to the exhibition's success. Ieva Hermansson from the Nordic Council of Ministers Office in Latvia and a delegation of her colleagues visited the Nordic House in Reykjavik to see everything with their own eyes. And that led to the exciting voyage of the Children's Book Flood's concept to the Baltic countries. The exhibition opened in the National Library in Riga in September 2020 under the name The Book Flood, Where North Meets Baltics in Children's Books. The creative team there did a great job in designing and producing the exhibition. I was really pleased with the outcome and believe that the exhibition's guests were as well. The Book Flood in the National Library in Riga was recently nominated for a prestigious design award. The Midgard Serpent has now swum from Iceland to Latvia and now to Lithuania to lead children through the world of Nordic children's books. He is accompanied by the ravens of Odin, Huginn, that means thought, and Munin, that stands for memory. They usually bring Odin news of what happens in the nine worlds, but here, they are the guides of this creative tour. Now I would like to take you on a short journey through the central themes of the exhibition in the Nordic House in Reykjavik, because these topics are also present in the Nordic Children's Book Flood that is opening today. Children's books, in my view, are very important. Reading is the key to learning, and it is vital that all children get that key. Reading can also, amongst other things, stimulate the imagination, expand the vocabulary, as well as the horizon, and contribute to empathy and open-mindedness. Getting children to be interested in reading books can easily be reached through play and creativity. That is the main issue of the Children's Book Flood. The children's book, they build bridges between people and places, And children can travel in their minds to faraway places, both real and imagined ones. They get to put themselves in other people's shoes, see things from the viewpoint of others. The Children's Book Flood encourages its guests to be active participants in an adventure amongst pictures and excerpts from books. The Midgard Serpent, Midgard's Ormurin as we call him in Iceland, takes the children on a creative journey from one place to another. In Iceland, the traveler put on a costume and they made their own passports so that they could stamp at each new destination. The excerpts from the books on the walls in Iceland were Icelandic books that have been nominated for the Nordic Council Children's and Young People's Literature Prize. The illustrations were from those books as well, but also children's books from authors that were the guests of the Children's Book Festival Mýrin at the Nordic House that year. There are all kinds of heroes, and this mural here on the wall, my students at an art school here in Iceland painted this one, and it shows you that there are all kinds of heroes, but that is also apparent in Nordic children's books. And the second stamp in the children's passport invited them to draw a picture of their own hero for their own journey. The pictures on the walls gave colorful inspiration. Some of them were painted by children in a special workshop led by me and the famous Finnish book artist, Jenny Lukander. The Poetry Mead from Nordic mythology gives children the chance to play around with the language, make it their tool to communicate their thoughts and feelings in a creative way. After crawling into a mountain or volcano, the children came across the poetry well. In it, they found the Poetry Mead, and at the third stamp station, they were invited to make their own poem inspired by the poet Thorarin Eldjot's work. Then a Viking ship awaited the visitors of the exhibition to sail in the children's book flood. In it, children could sail off into an adventure, have someone read them a story, or read one themselves. Children could also write a message in a bottle or try to catch some fish. Then they got another stamp from the ravens and drew a picture of the location of their story. At the final stamp station, children got the opportunity to draw and write their own story. And now we are celebrating the opening of the interactive exhibition, The Nordic Children's Book Flood. There are no limits to the imagination. When children make their own stories, anything can happen. And by engaging children in creating their own adventures, we encourage them to read. I really believe that children's books can make the world a better place and hope that the guests of the Nordic Children's Book Flood will enjoy getting to know children's books from the Nordic countries, become curious about Nordic culture and mythology, and feel inspired to read, write, and create their own stories. Through play, anything is possible. Finally, I would like to applaud all the people that have made the Nordic Children's Book Flood happen and praise them for their great work. I got to meet a few of you on Zoom and look forward to visiting you all and this wonderful exhibition in person and getting to know more about your beautiful country and of course your children's books. Thank you.
Ačiū, mėla Kristin, už puikią prezentaciją.
Thank you, dear Christine. I think all of us were impressed both with your creative work and with the first exhibition in Reykjavik. And you said there was a huge Viking ship, right, which could actually hold 25 children. But here in Panevėžys, I dare say that our Viking ship is even bigger and larger. sorry, but it's still the quarantine. So physically, we cannot invite the children much as we want. But now I would like to invite all of you to take a look at how good we were at adapting and adjusting this exhibition to Panevėžys library space. Of the Viking ship, you'll meet Pepi Longstocking. Yes, she lives underwater. And you will be able to braid her hair and also meet the other characters, female characters from the Nordic literature, and have fun. Relax. Just remember that our Viking ship will lie at anchor in our library until September, October. Well, I hope that I have whet your appetite and that you will find time to visit the library. And right now it's about time I gave the floor to our creative team. First and foremost, it's our illustrator and writer, Kotrina Zile, who's responsible for design adaptation. Kotrina, you're welcome. All right, I am the author of design, and I'm just happy to have been asked to contribute towards this exhibition of the Nordic book flood. I think this exhibition is truly unprecedented. Why? Just because Lithuanian readers really find Nordic characters so popular, incomparably, because we have grown up with these characters, beloved characters. So it was so nice to again go through my childhood memories and to remember once again the precious memories. But of course, we had to adapt these experiences and all the material of the Icelandic exhibition to the Lithuanian needs. Not all the books that were presented in Reykjavik have been translated into Lithuanian. So we had to, first of all, make a list of the books to show. And I got this information from our library. And also we worked, meaning by we, I mean a truly professional creative team. And yes, Nordic literature for children is so important that it can't be underestimated. And what I liked more even is involvement of kids into our exhibition. They become equal participants. And we, of course, wanted some physical involvement, but we couldn't. Just because of the confinement of the quarantine. But we simply, we managed to find a way. And we talked to the curator, Kristin Ragnar Gunnarsdottir, and also the children attending the Panevėžys art, art school. And they discussed the things and those children attending Panevėžys art school, they were asked to draw the characters. So here we are. Look, whenever you open the doors up to the library, you're bit welcomed by a bunch of characters. And what can I say as a designer? Well, of course, I had to take into consideration the color palette, the color, because so everything was in harmony, meaning yes, we have this huge ship and all the colors that I used are taken from the very space of the library. And I think that we can see that just coherence, the colors are in line and in harmony. And we didn't want the colors to be too conspicuous, actually, because we thought that the illustration, the books should be the focus. But if, well, I made the decision to actually choose a minimalistic design, which is, I think, the Scandinavian or the Nordic trend. So again, it's in line. And we simply wanted to convey this Nordic idea of the exhibition and with proper adaptations. And I'm talking about the choice of characters, about and how to best present all these books in this space of the library. So we had to think of some visual solutions. And it's very important to be working within a creative team of like-minders, and we did have it. I personally am very happy with the result. And I think it's very important to mount the exhibitions, which are not only meant to observe exhibits, no, but it's most important, particularly if it's for children, to involve, to engage them, so they become the participants, so they expand their just horizon. And I think that we actually succeeded in doing that. And we just hope that, yes, the kids will love it, will have fun, and we also hope that we as a team will be cherishing these precious memories. Thank you very much. And yes, I'm quite sure that our exhibition will be visited by lots and lots of visitors, and all of them, regardless of their age, will have fun. And right now, it's my, again, a pleasure to give the floor to Justinas Vansavičius, leader of the Literary Cognition Program, Vaikų Žemė, about the conception of the program. Hello, I'm Justinas Vansavičius, and I'm in charge of the Literary Cognition Program, Vaikų Žemė, first and foremost. I want to thank the library of Panevėžys County, Gabriele Bitte Public Library, well, staff. And this is a unique library, that's for sure. And this is probably one of the first such unique events dedicated to children's literature in an unusual manner. What I mean is, it's not traditional exhibitions. Usually, what do I mean by traditional? Oh, when we exhibit some illustration from children's books, or when these books are presented to the target group of adults as part of some cultural heritage. No, nothing of the case here. This exhibition is targets, well, children, and also it introduces the characters described in those books, and also it's interactive, it's dynamic, it's involving exhibition. And therefore, it's anything but traditional exhibition. When you come and you look at certain things displayed, and no, we wanted active involvement of the kids in the process of cognition, in the process of education, and we wanted all these activities that we are offering to make them more attractive, more compelling, so that every child would like to try, test his or her own talent, or maybe discover, unleash the talent, or just find out something that he or she has not heard of, and have fun. Very important is the fact that this exhibit, I cannot even call it exposition or exhibition, because the association is that it's something, you know, that you are a passive observer rather than an active participant. But I hope that the kids who will be visiting this exhibition, their parents and teachers, because we are, I think the adults are as welcome as the kids. Why? Because getting to know children's literature is important not only to the children, but also to mature adults. And once again, I want to repeat that we want to focus on very active engagement, not passive observation. So this is an interactive exhibition. And it's, as I said, it's not traditional, be it form or content. It's very important to mention that the exhibition is has been mounted in the library, and which means that kids, adults, whoever, will find lots of books within their reach. So after having visited this interactive exhibition and being introduced to the books, Nordic literature, they will be able to go to the reading hall or reception just hall and ask for the books and take them home to be read. And we hope it will attract many visitors, even those who have been not that frequent visitors, or maybe who have never visited a library before. So this is an educational moment. Again, this is a unique opportunity to discover lots of new facts and to be introduced with the library space. When we were working on creating the concept of this interactive exhibition, we took the ideas of the mastermind, Kristin Ragna Gunnarsdottir, as the foundation, I would say. And once again, our appreciation and gratitude just go to the library, Panevėžys library, for their decision or determination, courage maybe, to take the Icelandic exhibition to Lithuania. And yes, a lot of adjustment adaptation had to be considered, because some of the books have not been translated into Lithuanian. So we had to revise the Icelandic content and to present the books which have been translated into Lithuanian, so that the books were within reach of the kids. And we think we succeeded to create a challenging, interesting literary adventure, thanks to the architects for innovative architectural ideas, thanks to Kotrina for attractive design adaptation, aesthetically a very attractive adaptation. The young visitors, I'm quite sure, will find the atmosphere anything but boring. The books will be available, and this is the most important thing. Besides, as has been mentioned already, there will be lots of interactive activities. Maybe solving a puzzle, a riddle, maybe fishing a bottle with an interesting fact about the Vikings, maybe test one's talent as illustrator. So we simply want to invite our kids to be immersed into active educational process. By educational activities, I mean culture and cognition intertwining, and the education process, which we hope will enhance a child's desire to recognize the world and to increase the motivation to be curious, not to lose interest. The restrictions have been lifted now, so I would like to invite as many kids and adults to visit the exhibition, not only from Panevėžys, but from the surrounding territory and from the other towns and cities of Lithuania. You can just take a trip to Panevėžys and drop in the library and to enjoy this literary adventure. Thanks, everybody, and see you soon, I hope. Thank you, Justine. A very interesting presentation. And I also want to reassure all of you that there will be lots of interactive challenges. You will not be bored. You are welcome to come to the library even today. And also, many good words have already been said about the Panevėžys county, Gabrielė Petkevičaitė Bitė Public Library. And the staff, the librarians, contributed towards this successful result. And now I would like to give the floor to Paramia Sonienė, one of the librarians. Hello, everybody. We're truly glad, we're happy that we could contribute towards the towards this exhibition. And we, you know, bitter means bee. So metaphorically, we felt like those bees taking, well, just honey from the flowers to the exhibition. And I remember when we offered to mount this exhibition, and the first task was to come up with a list of Nordic literature for children, all those books which were translated into Lithuanian. And once the list were completed, we're a bit surprised. Under the category of Sweden, there were lots and lots of books, right? Translations. Whereas when it comes to Iceland, just a couple of books. So a bit of mismatch. Due to pandemic, as you know, the exhibition could not be held last year, but this year we started again working on it. Virtual meetings were held, discussions with organizers, etc. And tasks came flooding, our assignments. The first task, as remember, yes, for the first task, we had to use these tools, ruler and mobile telephone. Why ruler, you can ask? Oh, just because we had to come up with as accurate as possible dimensions of the books. Height, width, length, also the book when it was open, both pages, was width again and thickness, etc. And all those dimensions had to be entered and sent. Now, mobile, what for? We had to take pictures of the characters. Well, of course, we wanted to be our best, right? So that kept us busy. We started running from one space to another. The lights were either turned on or turned off so that the character could be pictured in its or in his or her beauty, all right? And so we actually developed our talents as photographers. There were other tasks as well to complete. For example, we had to collect the interesting facts about Vikings. Well, actually, we did not have any background information, but we thought, oh, that would be fun. And we started looking at all the references, all the sources and the books. And yes, we found out very interesting things about their lifestyle, about their just characters writing, runes, and many other interesting things that we had never known before. But you know what took us by surprise? That there were different versions of the same, let's say, fact in different sources. And we were not quite sure which version we should take as the most credible. There were other tasks as well. We were asked to come up with the quotations from books which best describe the appearance of a character. You might think, easy task. Yeah, we know the characters, we read the books, so it will take us, I don't know, maybe a minute. No. It turned out to be quite a challenge because when we tried to find the most suitable, appropriate quotation, it took us, I don't know how long. We looked through the book, I don't know how many times, and we still couldn't come up with the best quotations. And for example, we had to find the quotations which would best describe Carlson, who lives on the roof, yeah? Astrid Lindgren's character, most beloved here. We know that Carlson is a sweet tooth who can go on devouring jars of strawberry jam, right? Nonstop. So, yeah, I don't know how many at a time. And you know what? We couldn't actually find anything related to this jam. Because we started reading and reading again Carlson, who lives on the roof, the book, and we couldn't find anything, any mention. And you know, finally we understood that actually it's the understanding that we have from the cartoon movie about Carlson, all right? Whereas in the book, Astrid Lindgren, she described Carlson as a fan or lover of cinnamon buns. And yeah, So it was quite interesting to find out. We also had to find stories or legends which would be appropriate to present spaces of the library. So everything was understandable and appealing to the children. It wasn't easy. Why? Because, yes, it took time, you know, it took time. Yeah. But it was challenging, but it was fun. So we are very happy. And towards the very end, I want to say the following. Pokey rhyming, and we, on the basis of this rhyming principle, we came up with our own poem of four lines. Allow me to read it. We worked hard and we took rhyming, and we also took pictures, and we looked through the books, and we even started reading Viking runes. We never expected that. And we were mesmerized, enchanted by the Viking epics. And we even came up with our own poem. Thank you very much, everyone. Thanks, Palmira. Very, very just nice listening to you. And the rhyming, poke rhyming, will be introduced in the exhibition. So you're most welcome to try your hand, yes. Maybe you're a born poet, maybe you have a talent. And right now, I think it's time we listen to the architect and architecture solutions. And I think it was quite a challenge for our architects to adapt the Icelandic exhibition to the unique spaces of this library. And Justinas Dudienas is given the floor. Hello, I'm Justinas Dudienas, an architect. Now I could say I'm exhibition architect. And this library, Panevėžys, has invited me to adapt the exhibition, which from an architectural point of view is not traditional. Why? Because we knew what the content and the form should be like, because we had two exhibitions in Reykjavik and later on in Riga, where we traveled together with the team. But, and of course, we had to actually to create it under the conditions of the quarantine or confinement. And another unusual or non-traditional thing is the spaces of the library, which are extraordinary, I would say. Those who have been here probably know. It's a most extraordinary building in Panevėžys, and the interior spaces are also very interesting. Well, harmonizing different historic and new architectural expressions, and together with Marius Kushunas, we try to find the best possible solution. And this hall, spacious hall, and not overcrowded with functions. So we worked within a team. As I said, I worked with Marius Kushunas, who really contributed so significantly. And we came up with a different image than the one in Riga or Reykjavik. And we thought maybe we actually interpreted the exhibition as a trip, a voyage, actually a sea voyage on this Viking ship, and this hall was transformed into the sea, and everything is focused on the Viking ship adrift the sea. And And so we asked, yes, ask our little ones to embark on the sea voyage on our imaginary trip. And so the hanging space of the huge hall has been transformed into a huge Viking ship. And the moment the visitor opens the door of the library, he or she is met with those characters waving welcome. And we even tried to include the staff of the library, the librarians, into those host characters meeting the visitors. So they blend with the fictional characters. And I think that was quite a successful idea. But it's very difficult for me to talk about this exhibition as my sort of everyday activities as an architect. It's totally different, totally different. And all the team, some of us were from Vilnius, the others from Panevėžys. So we had to work, meaning there was physical distance and there was those quarantine restrictions, which didn't make life and work easier. But the process was most challenging and very interesting. Thank you for your architectural solutions and for a very interesting presentation. Now, don't you think it's time to actually open, to declare the exhibition open? Maybe we should ask the kids. I think I can hear some noise or turmoil somewhere. I say, hi, everybody. What do you say? Very interesting mixture. One, some of you say hello, the others hi, whatever. No, the most important thing is that we are here together. What do you think? Who am I? Magician. Yes, that's right. Yes, the magician. Okay. Okay, thank you for recognizing me. Do you know what magicians do? Okay, they are stage tricks, magic tricks. They surprise people and kids. Yeah, what else? Right, okay. They are here to surprise us. They contribute towards making our life more interesting. Yes. Today we have actually gathered in a place which abounds in knowledge, information. It's a library. Wait. What's this? Am I the only one who sees some ship? You see the ship? Really? I'm not dreaming? A ship? A ship? In the library? And what's wrong with me? I hear the waves of the sea. Can you hear that? Yes. All right. So nothing wrong with me, you mean? Okay. You feel okay when you see this ship, Viking ship inside the library? No? How do you feel? What's happening? I can feel something moving in my pocket. What could that be? More a carrot? Well, carrots don't move. What? A fish. A fish. And not a traditional, not a usual fish. Maybe magic fish. Okay. Maybe it wants to say something. No, it can't say, but it shows the way. It wants us to follow. Follow me, all of us. Follow me. Where is the fish taking us? Where is it taking us? Shows us the way. Here we are. This golden fish has taken us here. Where is it? It's gone. It's vanished. Where is it? Maybe it's hiding there. Okay. Magic again. Do you want magic? Let's say the magic word. Which one? Abracadabra or hocus pocus. Magic, magic. Is that illusion? No, this is magic. And you are welcome to embark on a magic journey. Not a usual journey. No, that's a trip of little recognition. And we are going to have this adventurous trip of Nordic literature. It will be lots of fun. And we'll understand the world surrounding us. I declare this exhibition open. Right, let's go, let's travel, let's unleash our talents, let's find more and more magic. We'd like to thank the guests, the viewers and the listeners, and all of you are most welcome. Those who want to explore, who are still curious, you're most welcome to visit our exhibition. You're most welcome to get involved into interactive activities. You're most welcome to dream, and maybe your dreams will come true. You're most welcome. And I just want to remind you that this majestic Viking ship will lie at anchor until the 1st of October. And for further information, please look at our web page of the library, now, Book Flood. See you. And